YouTube, and welcome back to the Loose Transistor channel. We're back with another episode on the build and review series, continuing on with the Colombian Carbon Middleman. So if you've been following along, last episode we went over the frame, what came with it, and we put the thing together and started to somewhat fit things together. I decided to take some time and talk to the guys from Colombian Carbon and get some ideas as to how to put it together, and also like try to test fit some of my parts. And I think now I got a game plan as to how I'm gonna do this. So a couple things that I'm gonna do a little bit differently or weirdly, depending on how you might interpret it, is that instead of using this bottom plate here to strap the battery, I'm actually gonna use this as a way to anchor my XT60. That's something I like to do because these things tend to fly out and get caught on my props all the time. I have so many drones that are fixed with tape because of that happening over and over, that I like to anchor them down with some zip ties or something like that, just to hold it close to the frame, and that seems to reduce the likelihood of this happening. So that might be something that I'm gonna do, and instead of using it for the straps. And I'm actually just gonna run the strap underneath the ESC. I don't think that's gonna be a problem at all. I have smoothed the edges around here and here where the strap is gonna be going over, because I don't want it to break. And I think it's gonna be nicely rounded and it should work out. So we're gonna check that out very soon. So let's get cracking on this build then. There's not too much to talk about it right now, but I am pretty excited about this build, so. All right guys, so let's just take a quick closer look here at the frame and how it looks all put together. So it's super simple. It's just the two arms that interlock, as you saw in the last video. And once you screw everything on together, it's actually rather nice and stiff, so it's not gonna have a lot of give. Should be a fairly easy platform to tune. It's just a true X design, but I really like the way it all goes together and how light it is. It really weighs absolutely nothing. So I think this is gonna be a pretty powerful build with the DYS 2206 2300 KV. I'm looking for a nice, freestyle build. I'm in this hunt now for a build that has a lot of low end grunt. I want something that I can blip the throttle and just launch it up into the sky and give me some hang time, really, the hang time, right? So, and I find that high KV motors aren't really supplying that. So now I'm looking for lower KV, bigger motors, and trying to run some more aggressive pitches. And that's something that I'm gonna try here somewhat. And I'm excited because this frame is really, really light. So I think that almost any setup that I throw on this thing is gonna rock. So let's get going here. Since we are gonna be using 4-in-1 ESC, the build process goes a little bit differently for me at least. So I'm gonna start actually mounting the motors first, and I'll get all the motors hooked up. Then I'll start measuring it out for the ESC, because that's gonna go down. I'm gonna solder that, and then I'm gonna solder some leads to power the FC on top of that, and then I'm pretty much not gonna touch this. I'm just gonna leave it there. So let's start off getting the motors mounted on this frame and take a look how that looks. So I'll just grab some screws here and get going. And get some Loctite so these things don't go flying and kill somebody. Always wanna make sure that your blender blades are well secured at all times. So I'm curious, how many of you have actually taken the time to go and turn off your filters, and how has that worked out for you guys? I haven't actually had time to fudge around with the filters quite yet, and my quads have been flying pretty nicely. I'm pretty happy with most of them. There's a couple that have a little bit of prop wash that I'd like to get rid of, but I'm not sure that turning off the filters is gonna help me out, because those are some pretty noisy builds. But yeah, I'm curious about you guys and what you've been flying and whether or not it's been working out for you guys. Is this enough? So actually I forgot a thing here. I like to put some shrink tubing on the arms to hold the wires in place. I just find it helpful. Turns out it makes a nice clean build too, so let's just get that out of the way pretty quick here. And I have scissors somewhere. There we go. Man, these scissors, let me tell you, these scissors are freaking dangerous. I was cutting some stuff a couple weeks back and I really injured myself pretty good, and it just caught me right there under the finger, and just, yep, I'm gonna stop bleeding. Use some super glue to stop it, and it was pretty nasty. So I'm scared of these scissors now. I try to be very careful with them. This is definitely not a frame for the faint of heart. It looks like the motors are pretty exposed. However, you're only really ever gonna probably hit the corners, not so much the sides, I don't think. And it seems to me like it would stop the motors from hitting the ground and the sides over there. So curious. It's a nice approach, I think, because it's nice and simple. We'll see how it holds up. Perfect, fit like a glove, so we'll just tighten them down and torque them down real quick here, corner to corner. So there we have it, guys. We have the arms, motors mounted on the arms, and the arms are now coated with some shrink tubing to hold the wires in place and keep them out of the way. And I'm actually quite digging how this looks already. Like, it's gonna be a really neat stripped down build, but it's gonna look kind of crazy with these motors. Pretty cool. All right, so let's keep going here, and let's get the ESC in place and figure out how we're gonna wire up the rest of it. So let's see. All right, I've decided that I'm gonna step up the gauge a little bit to 14 gauge on these wires here, just because I don't know, I don't like this. This is just way too chintzy. So let's just do a quick swap here and get these wires put in place instead. So we got the two wires there, all set up, thicker gauge, which makes me a little bit happier. And then all we need to do really is get a couple of wires to power the FC with. And I'm just gonna use some 22 gauge wire for that, I believe, because it doesn't need a lot of amps, just enough to run the board. So there should be more than enough. I'm just cutting a random long length because I know I'm not gonna need this much, but never know. So I got that. We'll just tin the wire real quick here. I've also been trying to figure out where the hell am I going to fit a capacitor for this build. And taking a look at the frame here, I'm gonna have to mount a remote capacitor of some sort. Or maybe I could do something crazy here. Mount it out of the back, so it would stick out. Let's take a look here. Oops, just dropped the FC. That's not good. Okay. This is essentially what we're looking at. having all the stuff coming out of the back. This is going to power to FC, so that's going to do its own thing. Now let's see where we can fit this capacitor here. Okay, so we have a bit of a monstrosity here. We have the ESC with the capacitor. This is a 35 volt, 1000 microfarad, 1000 UF. So that should do the trick. Now let's see if I can mount it the other way around without touching any carbon. That is a negatory. All right, so I just tightened the frame down, torqued it very, very strongly with a wrench just now, and that made a huge difference. The frame feels super stiff now, so definitely make sure you torque everything down very, very well on those nuts right there, the four nuts that hold everything together. You're gonna want to torque that all down, absolutely. So so here's where we're looking. We have the ESC mounted, the wire coming out of the back, and I'm gonna use that to like sort of hold things down. We have the capacitor here going off to the side. It seems to be clearing pretty much all the carbon. Everything is good to go. So then I can just throw a little bit of either hot glue or something else to just, you know, just hold it there in place. Make sure that it doesn't bounce around too hard. It should be way out of the way of the props. And then we can have the XT60 mounted out of this. And then the FC is being powered by these little guys right here. Might have to move them off and like spit them out the side or something like that, but it should be fine. I should be able to get the camera in there, no problems. Okay, so now that we have this section of the stuff pretty much mounted here, what I'm gonna do is tin the pads on the ESC and start wiring them up. So let's get cracking on that. All right, take a look at that. So we've gotten the first two banks of the, I guess this would be the front motors, already wired up. Looks kind of neat. Very, very, very nice. So that's gonna leave me nice and free to run the battery straps, I think. Or maybe not. Maybe not unless I do something like this. Yep, I have to do something like this. Yep. Yep, now I can run the battery straps through there. Okay. No problemo. You can run the battery straps, I think. Yeah, cool. All right, I gotta order some pizza. I'll be right back. And there we have it, fellas. So we have soldered up all the motor wires. Check that out. Looks freaking cool, eh? So all motor wires are done. I'm just going to plug this into my trusty power supply, and we will make sure that I get a tone out of the four motors here. And then nothing smokes in my face. So here's to fingers crossed. Set on this guy. All right, here we go. Contact. Perfect. So all four powered up. I just saw them all move. So we're good. Nothing's burnt. Everything is awesome. So now we can focus on getting the SSD mounted on and all set up. So let me just clean up things here a little bit and we'll get ready to do that. All right, guys, so we're all pretty much set up here to start getting going with the FC and start figuring that stuff out. So from what I understand here, to mount the FC, it's sort of like a soft mount dealio here with these little white O-rings. So the idea here is to put one O-ring in down to separate the FC from the from our friend here, the ESC. So I'll just put those down in there. So just like that, we put four little O-rings there to dampen things a little bit. And then the idea is that the FC goes on, and I enlarged the holes in the FC a little bit so that they wouldn't touch the screws so much, or at least that's the idea. So that would sit down like that, and then we can wire up all the rest of this stuff. It's gonna end up being the most sensible way to put it on here. Okay. I'm gonna end up mounting the board backwards and then reversing everything else in Betaflight. All right, guys, now that we got the motors all tested out, everything's good to go. We are gonna move on to actually doing the FC part of this build. So we're getting pretty close there. So on the Rotorgeeks SSD, which is kind of a neat board actually, I'm gonna start wiring up the receiver, and the receiver is over here on this corner. So you have the ground pad right over here in the corner, then it's followed by the 5 volt, and then it's followed by the signal for the S-bus. So these are the ones that I'm gonna use. I'm not sure yet what which one of my receivers I'm gonna use, if I'm gonna use the micro or the bigger ones. So what I am gonna do is just solder wires directly to the board here, and then I can figure it out later and just solder them from there. So let's get ready here to solder. Let's get the jaws of justice. Make sure I don't lose stuff here. Move all that stuff over there. As you can see, I am a messy builder. That's just how I roll. I don't like being clean and organized. That's just not my style. I just like to get shit done. So here we go. The board is actually really well labeled. It's hard to see in the video because it's labeled actually really tiny. However, if you look very closely, almost every pin is labeled in some way, which is kind of nice. I did look over the manual to make sure that I knew what I was doing and everything else, but honestly, you could probably just follow the pin layout here and you'd still be okay. There we go. So we got the three wires for the receiver soldered up and ready to go. I'm just gonna cut the bottom here and clean it all up. Actually, barely even need to. Okay, perfect, even better. Okay, so we have that part. And then right next to it, there's two little pins right there. I'm not sure if you can see it. It's having a hard time focusing. Anyway, those two pins are the VBAT. So that's what's gonna feed this thing directly from the little shunt that I made earlier on the ESC. Now I need to solder in VBAT, and also what I want to sort of do here is splice in the wires for the FXT that I'm going to use. That's what I decided I'm going to use. So let me just grab a harness here, and we can get that mounted. Here we go. So I have an FXT harness, and let's remove this crap here. Perfect, so these two here is what I'm worried about. So when I have some comfort, I'm gonna cut this much and leave about that much off for my FXT, because I wanna be able to have some play, not have to worry too much about it. Perfect. Now, I'm gonna figure out where or how I'm gonna put these two wires in here. All
I just want to make sure that there's no bridging anything here, because this is a very close joint. Very close indeed. Okay, so I have theoretically everything powered up here. I'm going to try to power it up very gently with the power supply so that we don't blow stuff, and make sure that I hooked up the FC properly. Go. Yep, FC powered up. That is excellent. No smoke. We're good. All right. So now what I sort of need to do here is map out my motors according to the wires that they're using, and we can go from there. So we have motor 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then we have 4, 3, 2, and 1. So it's pretty much reversed. I'm just gonna grab a piece of paper here and make some quick notes, and so that way we don't mess it up. My case here, motor 1 equals ESC 4, motor 2 equals ESC 3, motor 4 equals ESC 2, and this one equals ESC 1. Perfect. So now that we have that, that should just make it easy for me to just wire things up. So before we go ahead, let me just put this on here, get this connected where it needs to go. Come on. Make sure it's nicely seated. Boom, cool. So now that we have that in place, I'm just gonna do a quick brush to clean off some of this crap here. So just got some paper towel here just so I can clean the flux, because I hate leaving flux on the stuff. It just doesn't feel right. Got our trusty isopropyl, got the shit in there. And we just go on top here. Also, when you use isopropyl, you're gonna find out about all the cuts in your hands that you didn't know you had. Those are always fun to find out, don't you think? So that's better. I'm gonna wait and then clean the FC all at once I'm done soldering the signal wires onto it. So, here's our handy little map. Here's our handy little map, and we're just gonna follow it to start soldering the wires in place. All right, so we have ground, and we're just gonna arbitrarily choose a ground and use that for it. So pins go in order 1, 2, so it goes in order from orange, 1, 2, 3, 4, and ground. So that should be fairly straightforward. Let's see what we got here. So the first thing we're gonna want is, all right, so let's do this a little bit differently here. Let's just give it colors. Green. And then green, 3 is yellow. Four is E2. Purple, or blue. And then finally orange. Okay, so that way I don't have to worry too much, and I can just like run all the wires across here and then worry about putting them on as I go. Alright guys, so we have just one more signal wire to go, and then we can test it out, make sure that it makes the tones and everything else, and I'm gonna do some configuration, put the pigtails on, sorry, put the XC60 on, and we'll be pretty close to getting it made in soon. Take a look at that. That's probably one of the nicest wiring jobs I've done to date. So pretty happy about that. It's turned out pretty great. So I'm just gonna do a quick power up with the power supply again, and then we're gonna finish mounting stuff here, get the XC60s mounted up, and then I'm gonna take a quick little break to do some ESC configuration, blah, 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 all the boring stuff before we go and actually maiden this thing indoors. So here we go. Let's hope for the right tones. It's music to my ears every time. Just love it. Perfect. So we know that this stuff is working. Now we can hook up some XC60 action going on here. But first, I think I'm going to secure the FC down because I'm not going to be lifting it anymore. At least not for now. Hopefully I won't break anything. So the way the FC closes down in this case here, it actually is where the standoffs are going to go. So what we do is we make sure we dampen it with some O-rings because the kit provides more O-rings. Put the O-rings all around, and it also comes with these nylon washers, I believe they are, and you can use those also to like just spread the load and make sure that the poor little rubber guy doesn't get too squished down when you put the standoffs on. Cool. So it looks like we got everything in the right spot. So all I gotta do is power it up, make sure that it works, and then go from there. So I'm just gonna plug this in. We'll take a quick look. Perfect. So it is in PPM mode, so you just do a quick little double tap and it'll switch into, there you go, S-bus mode, which is what we want. And all I have to do is bind it and configure it, so I'm not gonna worry about that just yet. Let me just get it bound first. I just got my radio here. We'll do a quick bind, so we'll just hold. And then we'll turn on the radio. And we'll wait. Yep, we're bound. Perfect. Then I can worry about configuring this thing and checking it out in a sec. All right, so now that we got the receiver in place, all we gotta do is put some shrink tubing on it to make sure it's protected and get the camera hooked up and the VTX, and we're done. That's pretty much it, guys. So let's get some of this stuff here. There we go. So that's how it's gonna lay down. I am gonna put a little bit of some double-sided 3M tape on it because that's gonna help hold it in place. And this is the tape that I'm gonna use.
There we go. Perfect. Excellent. So that should hold everything nice and firm. Shouldn't be going anywhere. So now, what we gotta do is figure out the positioning and how we're gonna mount this guy. So it's gonna go like that, all the way back here. Taped up. So I'm gonna need like a minimal amount of wire for the camera. We have a harness here, our trusty harness for the camera. So we'll pull that out. We'll get ready to splice that in here. Alright guys, so I just went and configured my HS1177 to the color settings that I like to use, and I also put the 1.8 lens on it. If you haven't used 1.8 lenses, I highly recommend it, especially for racing. I feel like with the 1.8, the wider field of view, you can really see a lot around turns and allows you to position your quad better. I also feel like you can take turns a little bit sooner. I mean, it could be an illusion, but I'm pretty sure it works. And from other racers that I've talked about, they also like to run the 1.8s. Actually, the guy who turned me on to the 1.8s was Paul Norcala, or Boba Fett. And he told me about them months ago, and he was right, man. That stuff really rocks. It's solid. Brown thing here as the ground wire on the FXT harness. Like, come on, you guys could, like, I guess it's to differentiate it from the other ground wire that goes to the thing, but like, really, this brown, like, you could not have picked a color that was closer to freaking red. Like, it's the lamest brown I've ever seen. Like, come on, guys. Alright, so one more to go, and then we can solder this thing and be done with it. And I just have to test the video, make sure that we're getting video on the goggles, and we can do a little hover inside to make sure that it flies and it doesn't flip out on me. And all we have to do after that is just some tuning. So I am going to be doing a full tuning video for this quad, just because I'm sort of the guinea pig on this build, and I figured I'd show these guys how the tuning went, and so you guys can see it as well. I've gotten a bit better with the tuning now. It takes me less time. I can probably do it in two packs now, instead of, it used to take me three or four. And what I do now is, instead of going all the way down to three and then coming back up, I start at about four and I just like bump it up fairly fast, because now that I get a feel for what is going wrong, I know when I've gone too far, and then I just back it down a bit. I don't predict this is gonna be a very difficult frame to tune in anyway. All right, so let's just get these wires soldered up. Okay, so we have here the FXT. Plug this in, put an antenna on it so we don't fry stuff. Get this connected right here. And let's power it up. Alright, I'm gonna very quickly change the bands to a race band, because that's what I like to run on most of my stuff. One more, and one more. Okay, we're on race band. Now let's turn on this guy here and see what's going on. See if I can't get a channel. Alright, so let's see here. I just gotta fiddle around with these knobs and thingies. Almost there, it seems.
There we go. Boom. So it looks like we have video. Everything is good to go. Okay, so we're good. All right, guys, so the video is working. Everything looks good on that end. So all I've gotta do now is close this guy up and do the whole setup so that we make sure that it works on my radio and everything is set up. And then we'll do a quick hover inside. So I'll check back after we do that. Oh, actually, no, let's finish closing this guy up before I go and do that stuff. I got pretty warm already. Okay, so we got the camera here. There we go. So camera. So camera should be pretty straightforward. It comes with two little TPU bits here that are gonna hold the camera in place, and they go right in the front and they just slide in something like this. Slide it in flush. And I'll slide the other one flush on the other side. Got to do is screw the camera in, which is going to go right there in the front, and then wire it up, and we're good. I'm actually just going to put the wire on here right now and leave it on. Another thing that I like to do is put a little bit of Bondic around the wires here just to reinforce and keep everything from breaking. Theory, if I send down the corners of the camera here and here, I should be able to tilt it a bit more, and I have done that before, and I might actually do that this time as well, because it will afford me a few more degrees, which I do like. So I'm gonna go do that, send down my camera case a little bit, and I'll get back to you guys soon enough. Alright guys, so I took my camera to the belt sender and I chamfered it on the top here. I'm not sure if you're gonna be able to see it. There you go. So I chamfered that, and I chamfered the other side over here as well. So that's just going to give me the clearance that I need to tilt the camera back a little bit more and get it all in there. So let's just grab those camera screws that I had somewhere. Dear Lord, did I lose the camera screws? Nope, they're right there. Okay, never mind. Get this connected before I move forward here. There we go. Down. Just have to screw the other one in here. There we go. Now I'm able to get the camera at 45 degrees, which is what I like to fly at. So that was just a little mod that I had to do to my camera to get it to fit nicely here. Minor mod. I've done that before on my Saturn Ion. I had the same problem. It wouldn't quite fit unless I did that, but boom, perfect. Actually, now that I tighten it up nicely, it should actually hold it very, very firmly and it shouldn't move at all. Yep, feels very firm, perfect. There we go. Awesome. OK,
camera is mounted. It kind of juts out like you can see there, but I quite like it. It's nice and low profile. Got it up to 45 degrees, so that should work out great. Might even be able to lower the camera a little bit so it's a little bit closer to the center of the frame, so I'm going to do that very carefully. Oh crap. Spaced here. There we go. Perfect. So that looks good to me, guys. All right, so let's start sealing this thing back up here. Get everything taped up where it needs to go. So the next thing here would be to connect this guy, the FXD. Get that mounted there.
Okay, still some stragglers.
All right, so we just gotta get this guy taped up to the top here. I'm gonna use some of this trusty double-sided tape that I always use. So now to choose a top plate. So I've been thinking all along of using this top plate right here, just because I like it. It looks freaking cool. However, I've been thinking about it, and I'm not sure if I'll be able to mount my cameras to that. Let's just take a quick look here. These are the camera mounts that I use. They're just PLA printed out, just simple stuff. They break, but it's no big deal. It's cheap. Fuck it. Let's use the cool one. I can figure out a way to attach the thing. I'm not worried. So, how do we want this to come out of here? Nope, that's not gonna work. Okay, so that's as close as I'm going to be able to get to that guy right there. So now I just need a couple little zip ties just to make sure that everything stays nicely secured, doesn't go anywhere. From like flying out randomly. Keep that thing nice and solid there. There we go. That feels pretty solid. I don't think it's gonna go anywhere. Let's make sure that it still fits here. Yes it does. Cool. Alright guys, so we're just about to seal this up, and then I'm gonna just do some quick configurations to it to make sure that my radio is all picked up and all that good stuff. And then we're gonna do a little indoor maiden. And I'm hoping to get out today and do some tuning. And then the next section of the video will be all on tuning this copter and how I got it tuned and how it flies after it's been tuned. But for now, let's just get this thing closed up, take a look at it, and see what it looks like all finished up. Come on. Alright, two more screws to go here. Take a look at this beauty. Excellent, excellent. Awesome. Look at that, fellas. That looks awesome. Really, really digging that. So, yeah, I guess the other thing that I need to do is figure out where I'm going to put this antenna. Yep, that's how I'm gonna mount it, right here next to the antenna itself. I haven't done this since actually I owned the SRD, the HeliPal one. That's how I came mounted. I didn't have any problems with that way. So that's how I'm gonna do it this time here too. Alright guys, so we're almost ready to hover this guy, whoops, I guess maybe I should show you the right side. We're almost ready to hover this guy indoors and check out how it's doing. Before we do that, I wanted to weigh it and let you guys know how much the whole build complete, as you see here, weighs. I'm sure I could drop a few grams easily if I drop the circular polarized. However, I do like that antenna, it's pretty short and it seems to be doing the trick. So, let's take a quick look here and see where we're at weight-wise. And on the wife's precision scale here, let's see, make sure that it's on. La, 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 la. Ounces, nobody likes ounces, so let's go to grams. Boom, so just the drone as it is right now. Ooh, 311 grams. That's not bad. That's really, really not bad. If I drop that off, I'm pretty sure I can drop it to by 305, so that's not terrible without the battery. Let's see what it weighs with the battery. So this is just an average LiPo, so 468. So not terrible. Definitely not Canada legal, but I'm sure this thing is gonna chew pretty nice. So let's get ready here and do a quick hover and make sure that it works and doesn't explode and kill a bunch of little kittens. Let's connect the power lead here. Sometimes I notice that Dshot does that. It'll arm and then just disarm itself. It's quiet. Awesome. So Not sure if you guys could hear that or not.
Oh, let me just grab this guy. All right. So I'm not sure if you could hear that or not, but this thing flew really smooth. There was no oscillation whatsoever at all at any point in the throttle range. I've gotten pretty good at hearing it now because I had that problem with the hype when I first built it. So I'm like on the lookout for that sort of stuff. But that was super, super quiet and seems to be working fantastic. So I'm gonna get out today because the day is awesome and try to get this thing tuned, and I'll get another video for you guys in the next few days with the tuning. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. I hope you enjoyed the build of the Colombian Carbon. I really, really enjoyed this build. It seems like a freaking awesome, and like look how clean it turned out. It turned out beautiful. So I'm gonna get back to you guys after the tuning video with some more impressions of how the frame flew and what I felt the build process was like and all that, but so far, so good. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, check back in a few days because there will be more content. I have a few more builds coming out, like strictly racing drones, 5-inch, and I also have something incredibly special, the FPV Syndicate Stretch X. I don't think you guys have heard of that yet because it's a brand new frame. It's being produced by a local guy here in Canada out of Kitchener, and his designs are badass. So looking forward to bringing that to you guys too, so you guys can see what else comes out of Canada. So have a nice day, take it easy, and I'll see you guys next time.